Hi everyone, welcome to the Wednesday webinar. This is Justin Harrison, and as always, it's a privilege to share a few minutes with you. Today we have a unique presentation for you. Dr. Hill and I recently recorded a presentation for our European markets on the DDR Prime. Now understand that in Europe, the DDR Prime is actually called Novo Prime, and you'll hear us talk about Novo Prime, mention Novo Prime. Please understand it is the exact same product in every way, exact same formula, formulation, processing. It is identical to the DDR Prime. So even though you'll hear us discussing Novo Prime, please remember that throughout the rest of the world, it is called the DDR Prime. So this is a great training on this product. Enjoy, and we'll see you soon. Hi everyone, my name is Justin Harrison, and it's a privilege to be with you for this short discussion about the biology of essential oils. And we have with us today Dr. David Hill, our Chief Medical Officer and co-founder of doTERRA. And Dr. Hill, we're way excited about this opportunity. We don't often get to have brief moments with you like this, and so welcome to the webinar today.
Thank you, Justin. I'm actually very excited about our subject that we're going to talk about today, and we're going to be very focused with what we're going to discuss, talking specifically about the biology of essential oils. And I want to start by just introducing a concept. And the concept is to really understand just how far essential oils have progressed. And really, we could sum that up in a lot of different ways. But I think the three that are most relevant to the discussion that we'll have today is first that essential oils are biologically active. And we know this. There's evidence of this. When people use essential oils, they have an experience associated with them. You know, and I know, and many of our listeners know that sometimes that's very powerful, very unique, but it is an experience that they have. And now there's a lot of research that really validates why those experiences are happening. The other thing that I would want people to understand for the purposes of our discussion today is that essential oils are active not just at the surface of the cell, not just at this interaction point, but now we know that there's specific cell targets associated with specific essential oils and the activity that they produce. And this becomes really important because it means that we can have some specialized function now and understanding of how essential oils really interact with specific cells in the body. And then lastly, we know that essential oils have some selectivity. There's been a tremendous amount of research showing how essential oils are able to differentiate in different models or different representations of what a cell is in terms of its stages of health or well-being.
So to super simplify this, they work.
Well, that's really what we're saying, but and it is true, but I really want people to know that there's great scientific evidence for the
Absolutely.
Reasons why we encourage individuals to use essential oils. And in the context of that, I would want people also to recognize that if we really made it very easy to understand, we would say that disease, illness, is fundamentally linked to the cells and the needs that our cells have. And I think we all understand that concept, that if you support the cells, if we can really get to that level, and this is why oils are so critical and so important for so many of us, because if we can get to that level of detail in terms of our health, then we can have a significant amount of impact and be able to support our health in a much stronger and potentially greater fashion than what we've been able to before. So all cells then really, to Justin, all cells really need three primary things. One is that cells need energy. And what we're talking about is metabolic energy. Metabolism within the cells really speaks to how the cell produces energy, among other things, but how the cell produces cellular energy that's available for consumption and use. And that's an important critical factor. And I just give a reminder, everyone, that this is why we have the lifelong vitality. This
right.
is the one of the primary purposes behind it, is being able to support the cell with its energy needs this way. The other thing that all cells need, if we're going to be talking today about how we offer this protective sequence for the cells, is we do need protection specifically. We need an immunity type response associated with our cells. We need them to be able to withstand the barrage of different things that will come to us in the form of pathogenic microbes. So we need to have a daily approach that's associated with how we enhance our body's ability to be protective for us. And immunity is what we, of course, all think of. And we know that essential oils and nutrition are very well suited and geared towards doing those things specifically. But the third thing I hold out to be especially important, and this is what I wanted to have just a very brief discussion about today, because I think this is something that we overlook, and that's the ability of our cells to have resiliency. How resilient are they in terms of their being able to be dynamic with the environment that is continually changing, both with exposure and with the needs that the cells have? And so let's focus a little bit on resiliency and how we develop that properly through the body. And in the context of cells, I want to talk about a very specific response that develops called the damaged DNA response. Now, this is really the body's natural ability to be able to respond to DNA when it's damaged or it's impaired for any reason.
And we all have that, right? We all have damaged DNA on some degree.
This is why I want to discuss this, because it's not something that's unique to an individual. It's not something that only a certain group of people have, or only if you have this type of symptomatology or this type of illness. Everyone faces this. In fact, our DNA is damaged in three primary ways. There's lots of influencers, but the three primary categories we would say would be poor nutrition. And I think everyone can agree that we have varying models of poor nutrition associated with our lifestyle. Inflammation, stress that comes from oxidative stress, and so consequently, inflammation that's directed at the cell also becomes a primary concern.
Which is chronic.
Mm-hmm. Not only is this a normal process in the body, but this can be from an outside influence as well, an exogenous factor that comes in from the outside that we're exposed to. And then the last thing that I think we need to be concerned about specifically when we start talking about the DNA, of course, is toxicity. This is another primary factor that we see with individuals in this context. Meaning, just as you said, Justin, everyone has this exposure. And so the body needs to have a process that it can go through where it's able to either repair or to eliminate DNA once it's been damaged in the body. Something that all cells in the body maybe go through at one point or another, but certainly every individual has this process ongoing. So let's look at what happens when DNA is damaged. We really have two primary choices, two primary functions that the body's going to default to. One is either the DNA itself is going to be repaired, and there's lots of cofactors that are involved in that process. We need to have good nutrition. We need to have the appropriate amount of nutrition in its various forms, as well as, in addition to that, the damaged DNA, there's another option, which is, of course, cell destruction. If a cell is not able to be repaired, then the body has the option of eliminating that cell, a little bit of an immune response, if you would, in terms of protecting the body. The reason why this becomes critical is because when a cell is damaged, for any reason, it doesn't matter why it's damaged. Let's not even get caught up in the reasons why cells get damaged. Let's just accept that our cells do come under attack for a variety of reasons, and many of them are damaged. We need this type of a response because if left unchecked, then we have this greater susceptibility to disease and to illness. And such a big part of what we do in terms of our health should be in this model of prevention. And that's really what we're trying to narrow into here, is that how do we work in a model of prevention to support the body in its normal process, either to repair or to eliminate a cell once it's been damaged? Well, this is the whole framework around the damaged DNA response. Literally, when a cell is damaged, it goes through a repair process, a signaling process, if you will, and that occurs very quickly in the body. That really is a chemical messenger system that says, I need to be repaired. If the body's capable of that, then all is well, the cell will be repaired. If in a short period of time, and there's some estimates that maybe that's as little as 24 to 48 hours, if that cell is not capable of repair, then new chemical messaging is elicited that says, I need to be destroyed. I need to be eliminated. I'm not going to be repaired. And this is the part of the way that the body protects itself against cells and the DNA specifically that can become damaged within the body. So it's pretty straightforward. It's really easy to understand what this concept is. The question is, what do we do about it? Well, I'm going to go back to a reminder of the way we started this conversation, that nutrition, of course, is an important factor. But what do we do with essential oils? there's a tremendous amount of research now, Justin, that's in place that talks about all of the benefits of essential oils in this protective sequence. Some of that research talks about how essential oils can offer protection to DNA. Others even talk about how we can even stimulate the reversal of damage to DNA, this repair sequence. So it's important that we have both of those features in place. And I want to just talk briefly, if I can, about a new formulation that we have as a company that's based in this research, that's based in the significant amount of studies that now exist that talk about the ability of the essential oils to function this way, to be very specific with their cellular interaction.
Do you know what I really appreciate about this, Dr. Hill, as well as what you've just commented on? This is clinical documentation of the effectiveness of essential oils from various institutions, universities. It's not you saying it, me saying it, doTERRA saying it. It's third-party clinics really validating the effectiveness of the essential oils.
Well, this is the importance of ongoing research with essential oils and why when we're formulating products or when we're using essential oils, we have really two methods of validation. One is our own personal experience.
Right.
The other, of course, is what is the science saying? What is the research saying about these types of things? So we do feel like we're on solid ground with this product. And indeed, many people have been having very favorable and really positive outcomes associated with our new product that's called Woo-hoo! Novo Prime. Now, this has some unique characteristics. One is because you can see right on the label, this is an essential oil cellular complex. We're really counting on the fact and the idea that the essential oils that are in this supplement have the ability to have specialized and very focused targets. So let's just talk about the oils that are in this product very specifically and why it is that we would want to use it every single day. So I've broken this down into really three categories, and when we were developing this product, this is the way that we chose to think of it, that we really need to do two things. We need to try to have a protective sequence that can be specific to the DNA. In the case that we can't have repair, we need to take advantage of the fact, remember we said one of the great things that we now understand about essential oils is that they can differentiate between healthy and unhealthy cells.
Right.
And so we can take advantage of that and we can stimulate apoptosis, which is the body's natural response or cell death in the case of a damaged cell that's beyond repair. We can be supportive of that with essential oils. And then lastly, what do we do to eliminate these outside and intrinsic sources of oxidative stress? We know that essential oils carry a high antioxidant capacity, and we've listed a couple of essential oils here that function within that. So let's talk about the very first thing, which is how do essential oils prevent damage to the DNA? I'm sure that this is a question everybody wants answered, and I wish that I could answer that for you.
So we always talk about the fact that they do.
Well, we talk about the fact that they do because this is what the research is illustrating and demonstrating to us very clearly, without question. But we don't always know the process of exactly how that's happening at this point. So we do know that the oils that are conducting or producing that type of a response through the research is frankincense, thyme, and lemongrass essential oils. We know that for their individual characteristics, they've all been shown to have preventative processes in place to create an opportunity where we do not damage the DNA as readily, that they can be protective that way. And then we say I have this differentiation model where we induce apoptosis. Now, I think it's a good example of this is lemongrass, because you see that lemongrass not only has been studied for its ability to prevent damage, but has also been studied for its ability to induce apoptosis in the event that it is damaged. This is a really good example of what we mean by differentiating between different processes. And I wish I could explain in great detail. I have some theories as to why I think that happens, but that's not been proven in science as to why that happens yet. More research will come and we'll understand more clearly. But we do know that lemongrass, clove, and neroli can be supportive of when a cell is damaged, when it needs to be eliminated from the system, that they can induce apoptosis. We know, for example, clove can disrupt the cell membrane, and when that happens, we have apoptosis that is attenuated. And then lastly, oxidative stress. Now, we could put clove in this category too, because we know that clove has highest, an extremely
highest
level of antioxidant activity.
I believe higher than any other substance ever discovered, right?
It actually does. But we know that orange and summer savory produce the exact same outcomes. Now, many of our listeners are probably not familiar with summer savory, so just leave that in that oxidative stress category. And neroli, they probably are not familiar with either. But if we called it by its more common name, which is Melaleuca quinquenervia, that would maybe help them understand a little bit more clearly of what neroli is.
So it's from the Melaleuca family.
So it's from the Melaleuca family. And I'm really excited about the Novo Prime, Justin, because this is representative of an opportunity for individuals to start acting in this model of prevention, as well in this model of if we do have some of these factors that are correlated to our own health as a risk, then we can perhaps do the Novo Prime, and it would help to reduce our risk associated with that. It could absolutely alleviate some of these circumstances. So I'm really excited about the Novo Prime for that reason, and I believe it's something that individuals should consider doing every single day. We've made it really easy for individuals as well. And we've made it easy for them in this context, and that is that this is in a preformed capsule. Now, delivery is everything with essential oils, and so we've added an additional benefit with the Novo Prime in that we have what's known as a lipid assimilation system. And what this means is that in the digestive tract, we have a hard time absorbing fats. Some fats just don't really readily absorb through our digestive tract. And there's lots of reasons for that. It's that way by design. But in the lipid assimilation system, we have the ability to pass through that aqueous membrane or that aqueous barrier, meaning that we can absorb fully into either the lymphatic system or directly into the circulatory system. In either case, it eventually ends up in the circulatory system where the essential oil can be separated from the proteins which it has been attached to through that process. And now we have essential oils in a full deliverable form available for systemic use in the body. This is something that no other company is doing. This is something that's very unique to the nutritionals that are being developed by doTERRA, and something that I personally am really excited about because it gives us full access, or a more complete access, to the benefits that can come from some of the essential oils that we find in the Novo Prime.
You know, we've heard a lot of amazing stories already coming in from people that have used this product, and it's very new, right? People have been using it a very short amount of time, and you know, I've even heard this described as an insurance policy in a bottle to just prevent the likelihood of having some of those more major issues down the road.
Let's talk about what health is. Health does not mean that we're not going to have exposure to unwanted circumstances.
Sure.
That's not what health means. Health means that our body's been able to develop the resiliency necessary to withstand those insults, the onslaught of those things, regardless of why they're occurring, is maybe not as much the issue as what do we do to help the body to be resilient. So, of course, we're going to adopt a healthy lifestyle. There are things that we can do to reduce our risk, but we all are still going to have that. So I like how you really delineate that, say maybe it is insurance in the bottle, but I think health comes down to what we do and don't do on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. And for me, this
Absolutely.
Makes really good sense, and it's why I give a recommendation that people strongly consider a daily routine with essential oils, and I just don't know of a better delivery system than these oils with very specific characteristics designed to do very specific things in the body. And I think this is a tremendous value for anyone who would choose to use it.
So one question that I do get on this product, and we'll just close with this because our time is up, your best recommendation on use, take it with meals?
I think
or
it's always
without?
I don't really think it truly matters, but I think most people have a better experience when they use this product with meals. Because of its delivery system, you shouldn't have any issues, any digestive issues that develop,
right.
But why not just have the insurance policy of taking it with a meal? Makes it much easier. The other thing I like about that is a more fundamental thing. I remember to take it when
yes.
I associate it with, I'm not probably going to forget to eat today.
Yeah.
And so if I'm just in the habit of doing this with one of my meals.
You sometimes have that problem.
If I do this in conjunction with one of my meals,
yeah.
I think that's an excellent way to do it. So my invitation, Justin, is to learn a little bit about the Novo Prime. Now, I'll be sharing more information as time goes forward, and there certainly will be a lot of written information about this product as well. But if people will just take the challenge to have the experience with this product, I'm convinced they won't be disappointed.
I have felt strongly since this launched that it will give it a little time to penetrate the marketplace and let people know what it is, what it does, and it will become one of our top five.
I believe that that's true, and the reason why is because people will have a positive outcome. You know,
I
like that with essential oils, we don't necessarily have to predefine what something has to do for you. And even though I've given you some good indicators of why this would be really valuable, I can't think of a reason why everyone would not want to use this, regardless of their circumstance. So I'm looking forward to the benefits that this will create in the future for individuals. I'm looking forward to sharing more information about it and to hearing all of the experiences that individuals are having when they start using this product.
Excellent. Well, thank you, Dr. Hill. Thanks, everyone, for listening in.
Thank you, Justin. Thank you, everyone. We'll see you soon.